Blackstone Audio presents James, the Brother of Jesus, The Key to Unlocking the Secrets of Early Christianity and the Dead Sea Scrolls by Robert Eisenman. This book is read by Bob Souer. 4. Monovezos and Kenethios, the grandsons of the Ethiopian queen, freedom fighters and converts, who gave their lives at the pass at Beit Horon. Jesus, son of Sapphias, the leader of the Galilean boatmen and the party of the poor, who poured out their blood until the whole Sea of Galilee ran red, and Ord Wingate and Jonathan Netanyahu. Once perfection comes, all imperfect things will disappear. When I was a child, I spoke as a child, I thought as a child, I reasoned as a child. But when I became a man, I put aside childish things. For the moment we see as through a glass darkly, but in time, face to face. 1 Corinthians 13:11-12. Our Lord and Prophet, who has sent us, declared to us that the evil one, having disputed with him 40 days, but failing to prevail against him, promised he would send apostles from among his subjects to deceive them. Therefore, above all, remember to shun any apostle, teacher, or prophet who does not accurately compare his teaching with that of James, the brother of my Lord, and this even if he comes to you with recommendations. Pseudo-Clementine Homilies, 11, chapter 35. Peter, preaching at Tripoli. Introduction. James, the brother of Jesus, usually known as James the Just because of his surpassing righteousness and piety, is a character familiar to those with some knowledge of Christian origins. He is not so well known to the public at large, an inevitable if peculiar result of the processes being described in this book. James is not only the key to unlocking a whole series of obfuscations in the history of the early church, he is also the missing link between the Judaism of his day, however this is defined, and Christianity. Insofar as the righteous teacher in the Dead Sea Scrolls occupies a similar position, the parallels between the two and the respective communities they led narrow considerably, even to the point of convergence. In the introduction to an earlier book on this subject in 1983, Maccabees, Zadokites, Christians, and Qumran, I wrote with specific reference to James as follows. In providing an alternative historical and textual framework in which to fit the most important Dead Sea Scrolls, it is to be hoped that most of the preconceptions that have dominated scrolls research for so long will simply fade away, and new ideas will be brought into play and previously unused sources given their proper scope. When this is done, individual beings, the facts of whose lives tradition has distorted beyond recognition, or who have been otherwise consigned to historical oblivion, will spring immediately to life, and a whole series of associated historical fabrications and accusations evaporate. It is to the task of rescuing James, consigned either on purpose or through benign neglect to the scrap heap of history, that this book is dedicated. Mentioned in various contexts in the New Testament, James the Just has been systematically downplayed or written out of the tradition. When he suddenly emerges as a principal personality and leader of the Jerusalem Church or community in Acts 12:17, there is no introduction as to who he is or how he has arrived at the position he is occupying. Acts' subsequent silence about his fate, which can be pieced together only from extra-biblical sources, and to some extent seems to have been absorbed into the accounts both about the character we now call Stephen and even Jesus himself, obscures the situation still further. Once the New Testament reached its final form, the process of James' marginalization became more unconscious and inadvertent, but, in all events, it was one of the most successful rewrite or overwrite enterprises ever accomplished. James ended up ignored, an ephemeral figure on the margins of Christianity, known only to aficionados. But in the Jerusalem of his day, in the 40s to 60s CE, he was the most important and central figure of all, the bishop or overseer of the Jerusalem church. Designated as the brother of Jesus, James the Just or the Just One is often confused or juxtaposed, and this probably purposefully, with another James, designated by Scripture as James the brother of John, the so-called son of Zebedee, thus increasing his marginalization. This multiplication of like-named individuals in Scripture was often the result of the same rewrite or overwrite processes just remarked. There is a collateral aspect to this welter of like-named characters in the New Testament, even going so far as to include Mary, the sister of her own sister, Mary, John 19:25. These instances are all connected with downplaying the family of Jesus and writing it out of Scripture. This was necessary because of the developing doctrine of the supernatural Christ and the stories about his miraculous birth. James. The leader of the early church, or Jerusalem Assembly, in Palestine from the 40s to the 60s, James met his death at the hands of a hostile establishment before the events that culminated in the uprising against Rome and the destruction of the temple, 66 to 70 CE. To have been head or bishop of the Jerusalem church, ecclesia, or community, was to have been the head of the whole of Christianity, whatever this might be considered to have been in this period. Not only was the center at Jerusalem the principal one before the destruction of the temple and the reputed flight of the Jamesian community to a city beyond the Jordan called Pella, but there were hardly any others of any importance. For instance, the famous center at Antioch in Syria, which may have been confused with the one at Edessa some 200 miles.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.